hashtag is teach to reach. And there we go.
All right, good afternoon. 8, teach to reach. So why the number 8? Well, some of you might be familiar. We've heard some numbers today. There's 8 mathematical practice standards for students. So it's an awesome number. I get to hold a cool prop. And I hope in 5 minutes to ignite your curiosity about 8 highly effective math teaching practices that come from NCTM's principle to actions. So how's that going to go? Yeah, looks good. So ambitious teaching is complex, but how do we make it not complicated? Here's a quick which one doesn't belong. There are multiple solutions, many reasons, and it's like the practices, one of them together, you've heard a lot today, to have powerful, joyful classrooms. So we'll start with 1. Clear math learning goals, inform the instructional routines and the content. And in this case here, the math learning goal was use geometric properties to sort and compare the different figures. The learning goals also give the students a destination, a focus. And if you're going to use an app, navigation is a theme. You need to have a destination. What better place than to come here for this awesome event? That's how the app works. The second is tasks. This was amazing. Who wouldn't want to think about potato chips? All ages, estimating, problem solving, critical thinking, and they were all engaged. Now, to engage everyone, we need to have those multiple entry points. Take a car, take a train. Varied solutions. Give me a graph, maybe an organized list, maybe different arrival times, and maybe there's no solution yet. Thirdly, we want to connect to the mathematical representations. And you heard from others, my favorite two are the visuals. Do you see the fractions? Do you see the array? These mathematical representations really develop students' understanding. They know more about the concepts and procedures, and they see them as tools for problem solving. I've got graphical representation, numerical representation of the spike group, and the numbers, the integers, help me talk about elevation. We want them to talk. I had lots of conversations with friends why there's an Airbnb sign hiking in Maine. It got us talking, but in the classroom, we want to facilitate hearing student voices and listening to their voices more than the teachers. We want to ask assessing questions. Where are you going? Why did you do that? As well as advancing questions. We want them to analyze and compare. I used the wrong words for this slide. But we want them to see the multiple routes. Purposeful questions. We'll just move to that. I should have asked more questions on that same hiking route. And so when we talk in the classroom, we do want to hear the students talking about those questions. So I will repeat what I had prepared for the next slide. Purposeful questions that assess and advance students' reasoning and sense making. I had to question this route. I was going to school. I actually ended up following the kids with the backpacks and got to go through the park. So sometimes we have to question our solutions. Procedural fluency from conceptual understanding. This one's tough. But if you look at this map on the Grand, or sign of the Grand Canyon, you could just hike down, which I wouldn't recommend, or to take the time to understand all the things ahead of you. When students have procedural fluency from conceptual understanding, they're more flexible. They see things in a context, and they're prepared for some unusual traffic events. Traffic can be frustrating, but in the classroom, that's okay. We want to support that productive struggle. We want students to be uncomfortable, or comfortable, sorry, in uncomfortable situations. We want them to be thinking about those unusual events. And sometimes that dragon is an option and not an obstacle. This is a real Google search map. If you want to go from Snowden to Brecon Beacons, a dragon is an option. Lastly, we know that feedback really influences students' metacognition, their understanding, and so we want to look for the evidence of student thinking, take those patterns when they emerge, they're beautiful, we can have different patterns. And I encourage my teachers to do this collaboratively. It's like the Waze tagline, they're outsourcing traffic together. We can do this better together. Adjust the project, progress, look at the roadblocks and thinking students have, take everyone along for the ride, and So my call to action is to take these practices, which you're all going to do, those are all the yes answers, get excited, energized, and wouldn't this be great if this is what our math classes look like?